My name is Dr. Chemtai Mungo. I'm an assistant professor of obstetrics and gynecology at the University of North Carolina in Chapel Hill. I'm in the Global Women's Health Division, and the focus of my research is on improving cervical cancer prevention globally. I was born and raised in Kenya in East Africa, and growing up, I witnessed that women bore a disproportionate burden of weak health systems. I spent my time between the United States and globally, and I specifically witnessed a pretty significant disparity in cervical cancer, both incidence and deaths, where during my training, I almost never took care of a woman with cervical cancer, never saw a woman dying from cervical cancer in the United States. But when I did spend time abroad, there was a lot of women with advanced cases dying. And this motivated me to try to understand why there was such disproportionate death from cervical cancer in lower-resource settings and to do something about it. The current standard for treating pre-invasive cervical cancer is something called ablation or excision that's done by a healthcare provider. These treatments need people who are trained, but globally it's very difficult to access these procedures because there's just not enough gynecologists. Women live really far from hospitals. Right now what is happening is, you know, a woman is screened and has pre-cancer. She's given an appointment in 6 months or in 4 months because that's the next appointment to get treatment by a specialist. And then, you know, she's not able to raise the fees to come back to the hospital because she's a subsistence farmer. She doesn't have money to keep going to the capital city. And then 3-4 years later, she shows up with invasive disease. I'm looking to understand whether women who have HPV or cervical precancer can use self-administered treatments at home to treat their disease rather than rely on going to a clinic or a healthcare provider. If we can show that in lower-resource settings, women can use self-administered treatments to adequately treat HPV and cervical precancer, and hence this can, you know, and can do it in their homes, this can really increase access to precancerous treatment. So the potential that at the time of diagnosis, you can be given a tube of a cream and say, use this every 2 weeks, you know, for 10 applications and she can be cured, can really make an impact in places where a majority of women are dying from cervical cancer. This has implications in the US as well. You know, in the US, unfortunately, there's very deep pockets of inequity. So in the South, for example, you have higher rates of deaths from cervical cancer compared to New York City, San Francisco, because there's just much less providers, the density of providers is much lower. AACR has a tremendous impact in focusing on cancer research. Unfortunately, there are certain places that there's still a sense that cancer is a death sentence. Through funding research, we're able to, you know, change that narrative. And, you know, by having meetings like these, by having investigators come together, this is how we change the narrative for this disease. For my work to be honored in this big American conference means that the AACR is appreciating that cancer equity must not be focused on American cancer patients only, but globally, because innovations internationally will improve the lives of American patients and vice versa. And I think it's a manifestation of the importance that the American Association for Cancer Research is placing on global cancer and global equity, where we're looking at innovation and making sure that our current innovations are meeting all patients.